Hello, we all clinicians, and welcome to This Friday's Question. This Friday's Question comes to us from a viewer who asks, what are the advantages of a matching post? That's a great question, so let's find out. Okay, before we can talk about a matching post, we should probably quickly mention what is the purpose of a post itself. A post's function is to help retain the core material, which in turn will help support the crown. Historically, dentists thought that posts strengthened the root. However, we now know that cementing a hard and inflexible post will transfer all of the occlusal shear forces into the root and therefore will weaken the tooth. Recently, however, there is some evidence that bonding may help improve the fracture resistance of teeth, and bonding a post will also do the same. Therefore, bonding of your posts instead of cementation of them is now recognized as a key factor in success of a post. Posts are generally categorized by material, whether they are made out of a hard substance such as metal, whether it's a stainless steel, whether it's a cast metal, whether it's the newer zirconia type materials, and whether they are made out of fiber and more flexible type materials. And they could also be differentiated by their design, whether they're tapered, paralleled, serrated, whether they're active or passive, and then a number of other factors. It's now clear that active posts are not good because of the increased stresses that they cause inside the tooth. But we should keep in mind that posts are vestigial from the times of non-adhesive dentistry, when mechanically retained cores, like amalgam and cast metals, were the only available core materials, and mechanical retention was therefore paramount. With the advent of bonded cores, and the use of posts has decreased dramatically because bonding is now giving us enough strength to overcome some of the mechanical retentions that were required from the previous generation of core materials. However, many people still prefer to use posts for additional retention of their core, and when a post is needed, it should be bonded. It should save tooth structure, and it should not create internal stresses in the root. Let me just mention that it's important that a post's shear strength do not surpass or be too much more than dentin's own shear strength. Otherwise, the occlusal shear forces will transfer from the post into the root, causing root fracture. To use an analogy, if you take a look at the evolution of car bodies and car designs, we've now seen over the years that hard bumpers and those rigid bodies that were vogue many in the early designs of cars have evolved into shock-absorbing bumpers and engines that absorb the energy over a period of time. And the purpose of that is to absorb the force of a collision and then prevent those forces to get transferred down to the passengers. The same idea applies with the post. If you use a very hard and rigid post, the shear force of occlusion will not break the post, but it will transfer it into the dentin and it could potentially break the root. Also, on a minimally invasive side, we're historically used to use post drills to create post spaces for our posts because they did not match the shape of the root canal after root canal preparation and obturation. And that was because our shapes were variable tapered and we had all kinds of different shapes, and therefore we needed to standardize the final shape of our obturation and change that into a shape of a post. Of course, these post drills had the side effect of causing a lot of problems by themselves, such as removing either excessive dentin or, worse yet, perforating either through a strip perforation or frank perforation through the side of the tooth, causing a lot of problems and causing teeth to be lost unnecessarily following endodontic therapy. The first and currently only matching post system is the endosequence post system, where the post shape matches the finishing endosequence and ESX finishing files. This matching of the post to the file creates an advantage that the finishing file automatically creates the post space for that matching post. So once the finishing file reaches the apex, the matching post will definitely fit within 5 to 6 millimeters of the apex for that canal. This matching can only happen because of the system's constant O4 taper preparation. The endosequence post is a silanated quartz fiber post with shear strength close to that of dentin. As a result of this synchronicity or matching between the post and the finishing file, and also obviously from the finishing file with the gutta percha and the bioceramic that closes the gap, you can skip the post drills and simply have a post space baked into your shape once you're done with your instrumentation. Now that's progress. So I described a novel post preparation technique in 2008 that's only possible because of the synchronicity and the hydraulic condensation technique using bioceramics. I think the best way to understand this is through demonstration. So let's take a quick look at a plastic block where this technique can be implemented. Just keep in mind that you cannot do this technique if you do not use a bioceramic-based obturation for reasons that I've mentioned in previous tutorials. All right, after finishing your preparation using your ESX file, in this example, to a size 35 ESX finishing file, you should seat your master cone and confirm the fit and the full seating to the full length. You then take locking pliers and lock the cone at the reference point. You then take the matching endosequence fiber post and confirm its fit. Adjust the stopper on the post to the reference point. You will notice that the matching post is already seated about 5 to 6 millimeters from the tip of the finishing file. Now, the rest is easy. All you have to do is to mark the length of the post. Use a thin Sharpie and mark the length of the post on a sterile piece of paper by first marking the tip and then the stopper position. Then proceed to line up the locked master cone over the markings to visualize the length of the post over the cone. You will be able to visually subtract the length of the post from the master cone. Use a number 15 scalpel and carefully score 90% through the master cone, creating a very deep notch. The goal is to cut through enough to be able to separate the cone easily after cementation. Confirm visually that the notch is at the right length compared to the post. You then place the bioceramic cement in the canal and seat your cone to the full working length using the locked and notched cone. Here I'm not showing the cement for better visualization. After the cone is fully seated, press down apically. Turn the cone handle clockwise with your fingers, separating the handle from the apical segment. Remove the handle and gently condense the segment with a size 8 plugger. You can then remove the remaining BC sealer on the canal walls using ultrasonics and water. Make sure you don't touch the gutta percha segment with your ultrasonic and only touch the walls. You can also use the diamond tip hand instrument in the endosequence post kit to clean and remove any remaining BC or bioceramic on the canal walls and roughen the dentin. Once the canal is completely clean and dry, or at a subsequent visit, depending on how well you've cleaned it, you can go ahead and place a dual cure bonding material of your choice in the canal. Silanate the post surface once again, and then cement it into place using the endosequence core material. The core material can be used for both cementing the post as well as the ensuing core buildup. Light cure, place the cement in the canal and pump and seat the post all the way to dentin. You can then remove the stopper and inject the rest of the core material around the post to build up the core. After the final cure, you can prepare the core and then temporize. I think this video demonstration can best explain the advantages of a matching post. As you can see, by foregoing the need for a post drill, you dramatically reduce your odds of procedural accidents, such as perforations and necessary tooth removal, and you will dramatically increase your efficiency for post placement. These are the advantages of a matching post system like the endosequence fiber post. For Rewildendo, I'm Ali Nasseh, and I hope you found this information helpful.